The 1980s was a decade where horror movies became mainstream. Very few films from this genre have had enduring popularity like the dark teen vampire film The Lost Boys. This movie has become a cult favorite and consistently ranks high among the best vampire movies of all time. The Lost Boys was directed by Joel Schumacher and made old-fashioned vampires cool again. Leather-clad and edgy, the undead in this film gave the classic monster movie a much-needed injection of new blood. So let's take a look at how this movie came to be one of the best vampire movies ever made. The Lost Boys begins with a mother and her two teenage boys moving to a small town in Northern California. The older brother, Michael, is played by Jason Patrick, and his younger brother, Sam, is played by Corey Haim. While Sam befriends the Frog Brothers, a pair of self-proclaimed vampire hunters who love comic books, the angst-ridden Michael soon falls for a girl named Star, who turns out to be under the spell of David, the leader of a local gang of vampires. Michael's obsession with Star leads him down the vampire path too. So Sam and his new friends decide that they must kill the head vampire to save Michael and Star from the undead. On March 5th, 1985, the script for The Lost Boys was purchased from first-time screenwriters Janice Fisher and James Jeremiah for $400,000. The title, Lost Boys, was a reference to the characters in J.M. Barrie's Peter Pan, who, like vampires, never grow old. The movie was set to be directed by Richard Donner, and the intention was to model it after his recent hit, The Goonies. The characters were envisioned to be young and adventurous, with the Frog Brothers being chubby 8-year-old Cub Scouts. Even the character of Star was initially a young boy too. Luckily, Donner committed to making Lethal Weapon, and Joel Schumacher was brought in to direct the movie. His vision for the film was to make it more sexy and more adult. Schumacher had just wrapped another hit movie from 1985 called St. Elmo's Fire, and he understood the importance of an iconic ensemble cast. Schumacher said that he had one of the greatest casts in the world at his disposal, and they are what made the movie. Most of the younger cast members were relatively unknown. Jason Patrick was approached early on by Schumacher to play Michael, but Patrick had no interest in doing a vampire movie and turned it down many times. Eventually, he was won over by Schumacher's vision and his promise to allow the cast a lot of creative input in making the film. According to Kiefer Sutherland, Patrick was really instrumental in adapting the script and helping shape the film. Initially, the role of Star was envisioned as a Meg Ryan-type character, but Schumacher was convinced by Jason Patrick to consider Jamie Gertz, who he had just worked with on Solar Babies in 1986. Arguably the most iconic performance was from Kiefer Sutherland, playing the vampire David. His chilling portrayal of the vampire leader frightened audiences, and he did this with the fewest lines of dialogue out of all the main cast members. The Lost Boys always remained calm and cool, and Schumacher made a stylistic choice to keep his dialogue to a minimum, but his presence was extraordinary. During filming, Sutherland broke his wrist after performing a wheelie on his motorcycle. This is actually the reason we see him wearing gloves throughout the movie. To conceal the cast, the costume department outfitted him with leather gloves, which became one of his character's trademarks. His motorcycle was even adapted for him to use only his left hand to operate it. The Lost Boys was the film that introduced us to the two Coreys. This was the first motion picture that Corey Feldman and Corey Haim made together, and it would eventually lead to them becoming paired in other movies like License to Drive and Dream a Little Dream. By this time, Corey Feldman had already found fame with The Goonies and Stand By Me, and Corey Haim had starred in Silver Bullet and Lucas, so they were both pretty established before joining forces. Feldman's character, Edgar Frog, was inspired by many action movies from the 1980s. Schumacher basically gave Feldman an order to watch all the Stallone and Chuck Norris movies he could get his hands on and make them part of his character. So, Feldman did just that, and the result was Edgar Frog with Rambo-esque mannerisms, military dress, and the red bandana around his head. The fictional town of Santa Carla, where The Lost Boys takes place, is actually the city of Santa Cruz, California. Landmarks can be seen throughout the film and include the Santa Cruz Beach Boardwalk, home to the oldest amusement park in California. The city of Santa Cruz did not want to be labeled the murder capital of the world, so they insisted that they change the city name, and that's how it became Santa Carla. The vampire flight scenes became a trademark of the movie because it was a point of view shot from the vampire's perspective. The aerial shots serve as a unique aesthetic that were created as a budget-friendly way to shoot some of the flying scenes. The filmmakers used a page from the Jaws playbook and allowed viewers to use their imagination to fill in what was left off-screen. One area that needed to be visible on screen was the transformation of the vampires into bloodthirsty killers. Special effects makeup was used to achieve this and included prosthetics and eye contacts. The contacts used were made from glass and they did not allow oxygen to get through, which made them very painful to wear. During the scene in which David's hand catches fire, he sheds a single tear during a close-up on his face. This was really just Kiefer Sutherland's body trying to deal with how dried out his eyes were, but it made for a great shot. The Lost Boys did pretty well at the box office too. During its opening weekend, the film opened at number 2 and then raked in over $32 million domestically. Given the positive response and commercial success, it is no surprise that a big budget sequel was in the works. Joel Schumacher tried throughout the 1990s to get The Lost Girls off the ground. Despite scripts for the project circulating throughout Hollywood, it has yet to happen. But what has happened is a couple of low-budget direct-to-DVD sequels. Lost Boys: The Tribe was released in 2008 and starred Corey Feldman and had a guest appearance by Corey Haim. The film also starred Angus Sutherland as the lead vampire. Angus is the half-brother of Kiefer Sutherland. In 2010, another sequel, called Lost Boys: The Thirst, was released and featured both original Frog Brothers. The movie was produced by Corey Feldman and left out Corey Haim, who had died earlier that year. The Lost Boys remains a hugely entertaining and influential horror movie. It's also a lot funnier than it's sometimes given credit for. The movie has also inspired future projects, most notably Buffy the Vampire Slayer. Writer-director Joss Whedon has said that The Lost Boys directly inspired his work on Buffy. The cultural shift away from old and tired vampires to a more youthful genre can be directly attributed to the movie The Lost Boys. So, what was your favorite scene from the movie? Leave a comment below and make sure to check out the movie trailer for The Lost Boys, which is available in the description below. Stay tuned for more episodes, and thank you so much for watching.